In your headlines, another round of cash grants to be issued. Single vehicular accident leaves one dead and one injured. And COVID-19 spikes again for the TCI. Hey there, Turks and Caicos, so glad to have you with us. I'm Latoya, walking with your Monday, November 23rd edition of Newswatch. Another round of cash grants is now payable to eligible employees with Turks and Caicos Islander status. Government announced this weekend that the database for submission of applications is now open. Your leading story in Monday's newscast.
On Saturday, the government opened the database to accept online submissions from employees within various economic sectors in the Turks and Caicos Islands who were impacted by the economic downturn, a consequence of the COVID-19 pandemic. This second tranche of grants is opened only to employees with Turks and Caicos Islander status. It will provide cash grants of $600 to eligible employees who can provide evidence that they were employed at least 1 month prior to the lockdown that occurred on March 26, 2020. In this database, the applicant will see two options and will be asked if he or she is applying for the first time. The first-time grant is offered to employees operating in sectors other than the hospitality and tourism sector. Meanwhile, persons working within the hospitality and tourism sector will receive a second grant if they hold Turks and Caicos Islander status. The application process, which opened on November 21, will remain open until December 5th, unless otherwise directed by the Permanent Secretary of Finance. Applicants are advised that incomplete applications will not be processed. Therefore, it is important that you read the instructions on how to fill out the application to understand clearly what is needed, inclusive of the evidence to be provided. The government advises that the following sectors are excluded from benefiting from this cash grant: TCI Public Service, TCI Statutory Bodies, TCI Bodies of Good Governance, TCI Constitutional Bodies, Hospital, Healthcare or Medical Facilities, any water, electricity, telecommunications including of internet services, or other sectors encompassing the provision of electronic communications including print and electronic media, waste disposal and sanitation companies, and self-employed persons. Applicants must provide proof of Turks and Caicos Islander status. The status card number is the preferred means, but there are other forms of verification and validation. These are: copy of applicant's birth certificate along with a copy of one or both parents' birth certificate, copy of applicant's passport along with a copy of one or both parents' birth certificate, or Islander status certificate for the individual and or Islander status certificate for the parents. Applicants will be notified of the outcome as soon as possible following the submission of their applications. Successful applicants will receive an approval letter issued by the Ministry of Finance, Trade and Investment. This single payment of $600 will be made by the government treasury directly to the applicant via check or direct credit to the nominated bank account within 2 weeks of the date on the letter of approval. Application forms are available on the Turks and Caicos Islands government website. For PTV Newswatch, I am Delana Isles.
We'll take a quick commercial break, but do stick around. More Newswatch when we return.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza, Providence Jollies, Mighty's Plaza, North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to Newswatch. A man was struck by a vehicle early Monday morning and has succumbed to his injuries. And a female was also injured. Here's that report. The traffic unit of the Royal Turks and Caicos Islands Police Force is investigating the circumstances surrounding a vehicular accident that took place along Millennium Highway Providenciales on Monday, November 23rd at around 5:49 a.m. Reports are that two pedestrians were struck by a white four-door Toyota Wish vehicle while they were walking along the Millennium Highway. A 70-year-old man died at the scene and a 40-year-old woman was taken to the hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. The vehicle received extensive damages to the right side of the front windshield, right front wheel and bumper areas. Commissioner of Police Trevor Button, commenting on the accident, stated, quote, "Condolences are extended to the family and friends of the deceased, who was an active member of the local community and businessman in Blue Hills. When these things happen, it affects the whole community. My thoughts and prayers are with all of you. I would also extend a speedy recovery to the lady who was also involved in the tragedy today. The circumstances of this collision are now subject to a criminal investigation." End quote. According to the report, the driver did not leave the scene. However, he was arrested on suspicion of causing death by dangerous driving and dangerous driving. He is currently in police custody. Welcome back to Newswatch. One of the government high school's fourth and fifth form students have resumed online classes following a report of possible exposure of COVID-19. Here's more.
The threat of COVID-19 has sent students of the Marjorie Baisden High School in South Caicos back to online learning. Ministry of Health officials reported that face-to-face learning has been suspended until further notice due to possible exposure of the COVID-19 virus by school personnel. Newswatch reported just a few weeks ago, following the rolling out of COVID-19 community testing, that schools were doing well with no reported risk or cases. However, that has changed. Newswatch reached out to Minister of Education, Honorable Karen Malcolm, who was at the time in attendance at the opening of the wellness center being held over on the island, but did confirm that deep cleaning and sanitization measures are underway at the Marjorie Baisden High School compound as the ministry prepares to safely but quickly return students to face-to-face learning. Until January, a number of fourth and fifth form government and private school students across the country have integrated back into the classroom, while others, like fifth and sixth graders of private schools, have also gone back in. Minister of Health Honorable Edwin Aswad did express during an October 23rd health update that surveillance is definitely key.
We are concerned about that, and we are continually watching to see what is happening.
Frontline worker screenings has in the last few weeks been extended to teachers and school administrators, with all being sanctioned to the community testing sites to undergo COVID-19 testing.
We'll take a quick break now. Your weather forecast for Tuesday when we return.
In order to auto-scan your PTV set-top box, you need to follow these basic steps. Turn on your television and set-top box. Press menu on the remote control. Choose installation and press OK. Enter password, press 0000. Choose auto search and press OK. Go down to start search and press OK. Choose yes and press OK. The box will start searching for channels until process bar reach 100%. Click on exit and data will be saved. Click on exit again to continue enjoying the PTV experience. Thank you for supporting the PTV network.
Mixed weather patterns across the Turks and Caicos Islands. Here's your weather forecast for November 24, 2020. Starting off in the nation's capital on Tuesday, sunshine and mixed clouds, high 82, low 78, winds north-northeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. South Caicos on Tuesday, a few clouds from time to time, high 82, low 78, winds northeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Northern Middle Caicos on Tuesday, a few clouds from time to time, high 82, low 78, winds northeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Parrot and Pine Key on Tuesday, mostly sunny skies, high 82, low 78, winds northeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. And finally, on Providenciales, on Tuesday, mostly sunny skies, high 82, low 77, winds northeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Time now for your sunrise and sunset. Sunrise at 6:08 a.m., sunset at 5:06 p.m. And for your high tides and low tides, high tides 3:10 a.m., 3:24 p.m. For your low tides, 9:22 a.m., 9:39 p.m. Time now for your hurricane outlook. For the North Atlantic Caribbean Sea in the Gulf of Mexico, a broad area of low pressure located a couple of hundred miles northeast of the southeast Bahamas is producing disorganized cloudiness and showers well to the northeast and east of its center. Later in the week, this system may have another opportunity to develop subtropical characteristics if it becomes separate from the front and meanders over the central Atlantic. And that's it for your weather forecast and your hurricane outlook. We'll be right back with more Newswatch.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza, Providenciales, Mides Plaza, North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to Newswatch. Cases of COVID-19 continued its upward trajectory over the weekend, with one of the Family Islands reporting new cases. Details in this next story.
Over the weekend, the COVID-19 situation on Providenciales particularly continued to spike. On Saturday alone, active cases increased by 6, after leapfrogging by 14 cases on Friday. Prior to that, on Thursday, 5 new cases were discovered. The week had started with a total of 18 active cases. As at midnight on Monday, there were 39 total active cases, 2 of which were discovered in South Caicos. One person from among the 39 infected is currently under hospital care. Previously, one case of COVID-19 had been discovered in South Caicos in September. That person has since recovered. Meanwhile, since Saturday's discovery of 14 cases, which brought the total to 39 COVID-infected persons, there have been no reports of new cases. As is now the norm, the National Public Health Laboratory does not work except in the cases of emergencies on Sunday. The day is used to allow for appropriate deep cleaning and other preparatory work to be done. Therefore, the next dashboard will be released later today. For an overall look at where the country is with regard to its COVID-19 position, today the total confirmed positive cases identified in the TCI is 746, with total number of recoveries at 700. Total number of COVID-19 related deaths stands at 6. In terms of the TCI's testing capacity to date, the territory has recorded a total of 6,244 test results, with 5,498 confirmed to be negative and 746 positive confirmations. The number of persons in quarantine or observation remains at 122. This includes 39 confirmed cases, 83 primary and secondary contacts of confirmed cases, and one person quarantined in a government facility. For PTV Newswatch, I am Delana Isles.
That's all the news we have for you today. Thanks, as always, for tuning in. Remember, if you would like to see more of our content, you can visit our website at www.ptvatci.com or join us every weekday at 6:30 p.m. for the real news. I'm Latoya Walken. Until next time.